Thanks for stopping by. Today we're going to talk about macromolecules. Macromolecules are large structures that make up all living organisms. All macromolecules have small subunits called monomers, which bind together to form larger units called polymers. And there's four classes of macromolecules. They have carbohydrates, lipids, proteins, and amino acids. And I'll talk about each of these in turn, starting with carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are the main fuel source for most living things, as well as a structural component for many plants. Monomers for carbohydrates are called monosaccharides. Saccharide means sugar, so monosaccharides, one sugar. These are simple sugars like glucose, fructose, and ribose. Then your polymers are called polysaccharides, and they are long chains of monomers or monosaccharides. There's storage carbohydrates like starch in plants and glycogen in animals for energy storage, and then structural like cellulose in plants and chitin in insects. Moving on to lipids. Lipids have a variety of functions in living organisms, and there's a lot of things lumped into the category of lipids because they're all hydrophobic. All right, some functions include energy storage, cell membrane formation, and steroid function. They have no real monomers. They just are what they are. So fats include triglycerides and saturated and unsaturated fats. You also have phospholipids, which form the cellular membranes, and then steroids, which include all sex hormones, and all the steroids form from a cholesterol base, and all those are included in lipids, so it's pretty diverse. Then you have proteins. Proteins are involved in nearly all cellular functions and are a major part of all living organisms. Their monomers are called amino acids, and there are 20 different amino acids. Then their polymers are called polypeptides. You bind amino acids together to get polypeptides. And the protein structure results from folding, which determines the function. And lastly, you have nucleic acids. And nucleic acids store, transmit, and express genetic information. So their monomers are called nucleotides, like adenine, guanine, and thiamine. You may be familiar with these terms from studying DNA and RNA, and that's what their polymers are. They're called polynucleotides, and they're strands of DNA and RNA. Now you can watch this video about DNA and RNA for more information on that. And hopefully, maybe I can take some time in the future and make individual videos for each of these macromolecules, because there's a lot more information I could include. So if I get around to that, I'll link those here. If not, well, sorry. But I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, throw them in the comments. Be sure to subscribe and share this video if it was helpful. Thanks. Catch you next time.